भूर्भुवस्वः
भूर्भुवस्वः
तत्सवितुर्
तत्सवितुर्
वरेण्यम्
भर्गो देवस्य
धीमहि
धियो यो नः
प्रचोदयात्।
ओम
नमस्कार लिटिल लर्नर्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। आई होप एवरीवन इज सेफ, वेल एंड फाइन। In today's class, we are going to recall what we have done. Yes, little learners, you all have heard correctly. We are going to recall what we had done. In our previous session, we had done unit number 2, Wonderful Nature. What is nature, little learners? Every one of you know what is nature? Yes. Nature has provided us with endless gifts, isn't it? Yes. We have water to drink, fruits to eat, air to breathe, plants and animals to support our life, and much more to cherish. And nature gives us all its gifts equally to us. In this chapter, we have learned. In getting started exercise, we had seen how this boy is planting a seed, isn't it? And then we had seen listening activity. In listening activity, we had seen the different sounds of rain, like plop, splish, splash, pitter patter, rumbles and clip clop. And in phonics, we had learned sk and st. What are they? Consonant blends. Very good, learners. In this, we had learned the consonant blends, the sk and st sound. Sk makes sk sound and st makes st sound. Right? And we had done its exercise as well in page number 23. Then let's come to the next, that is language ladder. In language ladder, we had seen verbs in narrative, in which we had learned the different kinds of verbs. What are the verbs we had learned in that? We had learned three kinds of verbs. And what are they? They are action verb, saying verb, feeling verb. In verbs in narrative, we had seen that different characters in the story also say something, also feel like us, and also do actions like us, in which we had seen go, pick, make, wear, play and blow are action verbs, while saying verbs are tell and giggle. The one what we say is saying verb. What we do is action verbs. And what we feel is feeling verb. Very good. And we had also played a game of it in our online classes. Do you all remember? We had also played a beautiful game of quiz game of saying verb, action verb and feeling verb. Yes, all of you remember. Well done. And in pre-reading, all of you have made a beautiful video when you people were taking walk in a garden. Yes, every one of you have made it. Yes. And let's come to the reading portion now. In reading portion, we are going to read. We have already read and I'm going to explain you one more time. The reading of The Proud Little Apple Blossom. Let us read about two beautiful flowers which bloomed in garden, in which we had seen there were two beautiful flowers. What are they? Yes, they are apple blossom and the another one is dandelion. Well done, learners. In this story, we had seen that it was the month of May. It was the fifth month, the May month, when there was spring all around. And trees, fields, flowers and birds are blooming. They are saying spring is here, spring is here. All there were pink and white blossoms brightened up with the lands. And all the trees, fields, flowers and birds says spring is here, spring is here. All were very happy, right? And one day, what happened? A young princess came to the beautiful orchard. What is the meaning of orchard? I already explained you, a land where there is full of fruit trees, right? Bagicha, phalo ka bagicha is orchard. And when she saw the apple blossom tree, she stopped there to admire the beauty, to appraise the beauty, right? And after that, she took a little branch of apple blossom to her land. Then everyone was appreciating apple blossom for her beauty and the beautiful fragrance. As I told you, that apple blossom ka jo flower hota hai, usme se bahut achhi fragrance aati hai, right? The blossom became proud now. Now the blossom became very proud. I am the beautiful, nobody else is as beautiful as me, right? And as the apple blossom started thinking that other plants are not as beautiful as herself, the apple blossom looked proudly all around. She spotted a little yellow flower and asked, "Who are you?" And then the dandelion replied, "I am called Dandelion." By listening this sentence, the proud little apple blossom says, "Oh, poor little plant," said the apple blossom. "Although it's not your fault, how sad you must feel to have such an ugly name." So yes, she commented on Dandelion's name and pinpointing him, right? So, before the dandelion could say something, a lovely sunbeam, a beautiful sunbeam came there. What is sunbeam? Sun rays came there and said, "All the flowers are beautiful and all of them are same. Nobody is superior and nobody is low, but all of them are superior and all of them are beautiful." Right? By saying this, that all the flowers are alike, we all are same. He kissed the apple blossom and he also kissed the little yellow dandelion. Now let's see what happens in the next part of the story. In the next part of the story, just after some time, some children came there. And they looked at the dandelion with smile. Some of them have made a beautiful garland and beautiful string from the dandelion. Now learners, what is the meaning of garland? Yes, garland means a circle of flower that we wound over our neck and our head. Phoolon ka haar. Right? Then, the sunbeam says that the children loves the beauty of dandelion. "Did you see?" he asked it to the apple blossom. But the apple blossom was still and proud of herself. The apple blossom says, "Okay, they are children, so they don't know much. So they may like dandelion." Likewise, the apple blossom said to the sunbeam. But soon an old woman came there. she started collecting the roots of the dandelions. Why? As I told you, the dandelion is a flower जिसके रूट हम मेडिसिन बनाने में भी यूज करते हैं. यस लर्नर्स, तो इसीलिए वो ग्रैनी जो थी उन्होंने क्या किया, ग्रैनी ने, ओल्ड वुमेन ने क्या किया, रूट्स लेके गए जिससे उसने टी बनाई सिक पीपल के लिए, और कुछ जो रूट्स बच गए थे वो उसने मार्केट में सेल कर दिए जिससे जो पैसे मिले उससे वो क्या लेकर आई, मिल्क लेकर आई. किसके लिए? अपने बच्चों के लिए. सो इन दिस मैनर डेंडिलियन इज वेरी हेल्पफुल, राइट? डेंडिलियन हेल्प द ओल्ड वुमेन एज वेल एज दे मे एज वेल एज ही ऑल्सो मेड द चिल्ड्रेन हैप्पी, राइट? सो एवरी वन इज ब्यूटिफुल. वी शुड नॉट से दैट यू आर नॉट ब्यूटिफुल, यू आर अगली लाइक एप्पल ब्लॉसम, बट वी मस्ट बी लाइक डेंडिलियन. वी मस्ट हेल्प एवरी वन and we must spread happiness. So by the end the princess came there. Now in the conclusion the princess came again to the garden along with the maids and her friends and says that wow, what a beautiful flower, it's a dandelion, and I'm going to paint this flower, this dandelion, with the apple blossom. By listening this, the sunbeam kissed the apple blossom and he again kissed the dandelion too. Now the apple blossom blushed with shame as she realized her mistake, that everyone is superior and we should not feel too proud of our beauty, right? And it's a beautiful chapter which we had adapted from, which the writer has adapted from Hans Christian Andersen, right? In which we, in our notebook, we had written the word meanings. These are known as the word meanings, like garland, blushed. And here also three word meanings are there: orchard, blossom, and fragrance. We had read all these word meanings, and also we had written this word meanings in our notebook. I request every one of you to please read this word meanings regularly for your vocab development and for your better reading. You must read at least one page of English regularly before going to bed. Alright, this was my suggestion. And now after completing this, we have moved to अंडरस्टैंडिंग एक्सरसाइज, जिसमें हमने क्वेश्चन आंसर्स नोटबुक में लिखे थे, मैच द कॉलम और सिक्वेंसिंग द कैरेक्टर्स हमने टेक्स्ट बुक में किया था, राइट? एंड देन वी हैड केम टू वोकैबुलरी. इन वोकैबुलरी वी हैड सीन क्वांटिटी वर्ड्स. यस लर्नर्स, वोकैबुलरी में हमने क्या देखा था? क्वांटिटी वर्ड्स, जो हमने थर्ड ए, थर्ड सी, थर्ड बी एंड थर्ड डी चारों सेक्शन में कर लिया था, राइट? जिसमें हमने काउंटेबल एंड अनकाउंटेबल नाउन्स में देखा था, क्या देखा था? क्वांटिटी वर्ड्स. लाइक टर्न द पेज, कम टू पेज नंबर 28. यस, वी हैव सीन डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ वर्ड्स. लाइक मैनी मीन्स a large quantity of anything, a large quantity of noun. Which kind of noun? Countable noun. Countable nouns are the nouns which we can count in our fingers, or which is countable. Uncountable nouns which we cannot count, right? And few is used for very small quantity, which is used in countable nouns. Now much and little. Much is used for a large quantity for uncountable noun, and little is used for very small quantity for which kind of noun? Uncountable noun. Now all and some are used with both countable as well as with uncountable nouns, in which we had seen दैट ऑल इज यूज फॉर द एंटायर क्वांटिटी, पूरी क्वांटिटी के लिए. जब हम सभी के बारे में बात करते हैं तब हम ऑल का यूज करते हैं, और जब हम थोड़ी सी क्वांटिटी के बारे में बात करते हैं तब हम सम का यूज करते हैं. एंड देन हमने उससे रिलेटेड एक्सरसाइजेस भी की थी. एंड देन जो वर्ब्स इन नरेटिव मैंने आपको समझाए थे, यस, सेइंग वर्ब, फीलिंग वर्ब एंड एक्शन वर्ब्स, उसी की प्रैक्टिसिंग एक्सरसाइज यहाँ पे दी हुई है जो हमने कर ली है ऑलरेडी. नाउ लेट्स टर्न एंड लेट्स कम टू स्पीकिंग पोलाइटली. एवरीवन वांट्स टू बी पोलाइट, इजंट इट? डू यू वांट टू बी पोलाइट? यस. इन स्पीकिंग पोलाइटली वी हैड सीन फ्यू वर्ड्स लाइक, जैसा कि आप लोगों ने ऑलरेडी वर्ड्स देखे ही हैं, थैंक यू, प्लीज, मैजिकल वर्ड्स. एवरीवन नोस द मैजिकल वर्ड्स? यस. व्हाट आर द मैजिकल वर्ड्स? प्लीज, थैंक यू, एटसेट्रा. द वर्ड्स मेक्स अस टू फील बेटर एंड इन इट इज यूज्ड इन polite language, right? And we must talk with everyone in polite language, like would, please, please, and thank you. When somebody helps us, we must say thank you to them. If we want somebody to do our work, we must say, can you please help me? Yeah, could you please help me? Could and would and please, these all are the words which we use for speaking politely. And then we had done a plug-in activity, जिसमें मैंने आपको tenses के बारे में समझाया था. What are tense? Tense in grammar, not tense in feeling, okay? उदासी वाला tense नहीं, but grammar वाला tense. जिसमें हमने क्या देखा था? Three kinds of tenses are there. What are they? Present, past, present and future, right? In which past tense क्या होते हैं बच्चों? Past tense are the tense जिसमें हमने work या action already कर लिया होता है past में. Present मतलब जिसमें action चल रहा होता है. Future means जिसमें action take place करेगा future में, जिसमें हम future tense में will और shall का use करते हैं. प्रेजेंट में इज एम आर प्लस आईएनजी का यूज़ करते हैं एंड पास्ट में वॉज और वर का यूज़ करते हैं, राइट? इससे रिलेटेड हमने फिर प्लग इन एक्टिविटी में देखा था सिंपल फ्यूचर टेंस, जिसमें हमने विल और शैल का यूज़ करके बहुत सारे सेंटेंसेस बनाए थे. नाउ लेट्स टर्न द पेज, कम टू राइटिंग पोर्शन. नेक्स्ट इज आर राइटिंग पोर्शन, डायरेक्शन इन विच देर इज अ ट्रेजर हंट, जिसमें हमें प्रिंसेस को ट्रेजर तक लेके जाना था. एंड वी हैड रिटन अ ब्यूटिफुल कमेंट्स टू टेक द प्रिंसेस टू द ट्रेजर बाय द हेल्प ऑफ दिस हेल्पिंग हैंड. गो स्ट्रेट एंड टेक द राइट, गो लेफ्ट जस्ट आफ्टर यू सी द बनाना ट्रीज, देन walk along the road till you see the bunches of houses, then bunches of house, then turn the right and follow the road till you see a bunch of house, and after that turn left just before the house and follow the road, and the road will take you to the treasure. Then we had seen the poem, our poem number, yes, poem number 2, the little plants, जिसमें हमने देखा था there was a beautiful little seed of plant sleeping under the soil, right? And the sunbeams, the sunlight, the sun rays, or we can say the sunshines were creeping to the light and were saying, wake up, wake up, see the world, it's a beautiful world. And the raindrop also helped the sun to help to make wake up the seeds and into the plant, like in the heart of the seed, buried deep so deep, a dear little plant lays fast asleep. Wakes it the sunshine and creep to the light. Sunshine क्या बोलती है little seed को? Wake up. Wakes it the voice of raindrop bright. The little plant heard and it rose to see what is wonderful outside world might be. ब्यूटिफुल वर्ल्ड देखने के लिए फिर वो प्लांट सीड जो है वो कहाँ से निकलता है? सॉइल से, विद द हेल्प ऑफ सनलाइट एंड रेन ड्रॉप्स. जैसे ही रेन ड्रॉप्स और सनलाइट उस पर गिरती हैं, एक ब्यूटिफुल सा प्लांट बन जाता है, राइट, उग जाता है. एंड रिलेटेड टू इट वी हैड डन द पोयम अप्रिसिएशन. देर वॉज अ एक्सरसाइज Like question number 1, answer the following question which we had done in our notebook recently. And question number 2, that is take the correct option, we have done in our textbook. Then homophones, what are homophones learners? The words that sounds the same but have different meaning with different spellings, very good. We had done a beautiful exercise of homophones. And then comes the enrichment, all of your favorite part. In enrichment, we had seen different kinds of posters. Why we have to make these posters? Yes, to create awareness, to make people aware, to spread the awareness about saving trees. Why? Because trees helps to make medicines. It also helps in various manner. Like in day-to-day life, trees helps us a lot. It gives us oxygen, which is very important for us to live in, to breathe in, right? And if we cut the trees, it's our loss ultimately, right? So we should not cut the trees. Instead of cutting trees, we must grow trees, isn't it? Yes. With it, we have to write few lines about saving trees in simple future tense, which we had written as it was your homework. This one was your homework in which you all have to write sentences in simple future tense. ये मैंने आपको video lesson online classes में homework में दिया था, जिसमें आप लोगों को क्या करना था, sentences लिखने थे. किसमें? Simple future tense में. Okay? On what will happen to us if we cut down all the trees? अगर हम सारी trees को cut कर देंगे तो क्या होगा? वो आपको लिखना था सिंपल फ्यूचर टेंस में, राइट. आई होप कि आप लोगों ने बहुत अच्छे से सब किया होगा. सी सेक्शन में ऑलरेडी ये पोर्शन हो चुका था. ए बी एंड डी में रिमेनिंग था, जो हम लोगों ने अभी रिसेंट की क्लासेस में कंप्लीट किया है, राइट. एंड एनी वन ऑफ यू फील ट्रबल इन चैप्टर नंबर 2, सो दिस वीडियो इज for the revision, for your recalling. So recall the chapter nicely, and then also if you face any difficulty, any problem in any of the topic, feel free to tell me, right, to talk to me. I'll be there to help you. And I hope कि इसके बाद आप लोगों को ज़्यादा queries नहीं होगी, आप लोगों को easily chapter समझ में आ गया होगा, right. एंड चैप्टर की एक्सरसाइजेस, पोयम में आप लोगों को बहुत मज़ा आया होगा. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडेज लेसन. सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लासेस. बाय, टेक केयर, थैंक यू एंड नमस्कार.